Praise the Lord. Welcome to the series of Watchword from Kadosh Marian Ministries. Jesus, our light and our salvation. Jesus is the promised light of the world as prophesied in Isaiah chapter 9 verses 2. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. Sin brings death and darkness into the world. St. Paul urges us in Ephesians chapter 5 against this very thing, that we are not to be a part of the unfruitful works of darkness. Rather, we, as children of light, are to expose the works of darkness by walking in the light of Christ, by walking in holiness and righteousness, by putting on Christ daily. There is only one way to escape the darkness, and that is when we come to Jesus as our Lord and Savior, the light of the world. Just as God in His faithfulness and love led the people of Israel through their 40 years of wilderness as a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night till they reached the promised land, Jesus, our light, leads us, the sons and daughters of God, through our earthly lives into life eternal. The light of Christ enlightens our darkened minds and reveals to us the fullness of God's love, His word that is true, holy and eternal. When it goes out from His mouth, it will never return empty, but will accomplish what He desires and achieves the purpose for which He sends it forth. His nature, His ways, His promises for all who have the eyes to see and the ears to hear. Are we sensitive to the gentle Holy Spirit who constantly pursues our hearts? The Lord invites us every day, dear brothers and sisters, to enter into His light and the rest that comes with it. As we allow the light of Christ to shine on our lives, on ourselves, all the darkness we've known will disappear from our lives. Just as we need light for the sustenance and growth of our physical lives, we need the light of Christ for our spiritual life. In John 9, we see that Jesus heals the man who was born blind and had always lived in physical darkness, not knowing light. And Jesus delivered him from that physical darkness, bringing light to his eyes. And through his healing, he comes to see the light of truth about Jesus as the Son of the living God. Jesus is our only guide through this dark world and life, which can be so full of uncertainties. But only one thing remains constant, and that is the love of God for us in Christ Jesus. As long as we walk in His light, we will not stumble. So let our prayer be like that of the psalmist. Lord, Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light unto my path. Yes, we may have struggles and trials in this life, but with Jesus, we are assured of our inheritance that will never spoil, it will never perish, neither will it fade, unlike our earthly inheritance and possessions that are prone to all these possibilities. So we do not fear. We can be at complete peace because our inheritance is reserved in heaven according to 1 Peter 1 verse 4. As we choose to walk in the light of Jesus, let us reflect that light around us. Love as He loved us. Bear our crosses with patience and trust in God, knowing that He will never give us more than we could bear. Let us constantly deny works of the flesh and darkness and expose it with the light of God's word. Let us touch the lives of people around us as we journey through life. Let us shine the light of Christ by doing the good works that He has prepared for us, giving Him all the glory so that many would enter the kingdom of God. May the light of Christ dispel all darkness within and on the outside, bringing out of darkness those who are imprisoned, breaking the chains and bondages that confine them, leading them into a life of freedom, into life eternal. This is Sandra Fonseca Collins from Kadosh Marian Ministry. God bless you all.